and has fallen over the side, and the person grips their, holds their hand, but they can't hold them for much longer, and they have to, sometimes they have to let go. And so, but when God has you, when your hand is in the hand of the man that still waters and calms the sea, when he holds on to you, he won't let you go. He won't let you fall. His hand is so, his arm is so strong, he will hold you through. So, let us, allow the Lord to hold us through in his time. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Crash about 3 Sundays ago in Jamaica. That's not very far from my state. And actually, my husband was caught up in it. But you know, it happened just before he got there, and he got caught up in all of it. And I gave God thanks because of him being one of them that had died. A few has died from it, and all because of carelessness. But you know, God knows everything. Yeah. He put us in the right place. Mm. If we continue to lean on him, he will lead us to the right place. He's never late, he's always in time. So when we are rushing, we may not get to come into big time. It's God that's holding us back. Because something in front of us is not for us. There's danger. So yes, you might be always get upset and say that we are late. Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. And God said no. He's always on time, he's never late. And whatever way we're going, whatever we're doing, if we get there later, that's the best thing for us. Mm-hmm. Because we may not have gotten there at all, because we could have died or something would have happened. So I give God thanks, I give him the other glory again. And I said, it's nice to see you all again. And I'm very happy to be back in the house of the Lord to worship with him. Thank you all for every time. Thanks for your prayers. And every time that we pray, and I give you thanks for all your prayers, because prayers are very much, and you've covered me and my family. And I'd like to thank you all. Thanks very much.
Amen.
Back in without that we could not afford to do this. So we just give you thanks. and ask the blessed Lord, as we said, sanctify Lord Jesus, and let the storehouses of everyone that baptism will never be empty, because they have returned a portion of what you said unto you there, and they have returned a portion. So bless my God, and many times for your blessings in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Take it. body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner, he took the cup, and when he had supped, said, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood. Do this, as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as he eat this bread and drink this cup, he do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For if he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not deserving the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with this world. Wherefore, my brethren, when you do come together to eat, tarry one for another. And if any man hungry, let him eat at home, that he come not together unto condemnation. And the rest that I say in all that I come. Bless you. I invite our sisters to come and sing for us. And God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you.
here to remember the nail prints in his hands and in his feet. And here to remember, praise the name of Jesus. He is worthy. Praise the name of God. But now as ministers of prayer upon this, upon the bread and the wine. Praise God.
Oh, good.
this do in remembrance of me? Eat all. And after the same manner, also, he took the cup, and when he had supped, saying, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye, as often as ye drink it, in remembrance of me." Mighty God, I am blessed. I can't think of a better place to be right now. Amen.
academic, what have they achieved? Someone to be very, very rich and have all the money that they can accumulate. Someone has many, many reasons for living.
Yes.
But Jesus is my reason for living. He's my source.
Today, if ye will hear his voice, We go to many trials, tribulation, troubles, fear, doubt, temptation. And almost, there's always seems to be one thing after another. It just continues. Every day, there's something. There's something to test, there's something to try us. But Jesus, what Paul is saying, God has got a time when we shall rest, every one of us, from our labor. One day, Jesus says he's going to prepare a place. That he said, where he is, we may be also.
Amen.
So he says, it's right, he said, let us therefore fear the promise. There is a promise. God promised, made a promise to us. He promised that he's going to come back again. He's coming back again. He went away, not to stay, he's coming back again. That is a promise. And if we look for him, we will see him. You know, when we see what is going on in the world today, my brethren, and when we consider the threat of war, nuclear war, and all those things that's going on, the various diseases and all that's going on, there's so many things going on all around us. There's so many things that cause us to wonder, to fear what's going on. But Jesus had told his disciples what to expect in the last days. So we know. We know that these things must come to pass. It's not if or but, or maybe, they must come to pass. And so we know, but we are not to be distracted. Because everything that's happening around us is served as a distraction. You know? Wars, disease, pestilence. You know, mentioned about the Jamaica accident and these things, and what we hear is one terrible things happening. You know, people died in accidents and things like that. It's there to distract us. We are to keep our eyes on Jesus.
Amen.
Not be fearful. Stand upon his word. He said, I will be with you unto the end of the world. He's a comforter. He said, when he was about to ascend, he said, I'm going. But the comforter will come in my name. So the comforter comes in the name of Jesus to comfort us in many ways, to be with us, to guide us, and to protect us, and to strengthen us, and to keep us standing on the solid rock. Let us therefore fear. Fear don't mean that we must be afraid. It just means that we must let us keep our eyes on Jesus. Let us reverence him. Let us give him all the praise and the glory and the honor that is due to him. Let us continue in thanksgiving. Pray without ceasing. And in all things, it says, in all things, give thanks. Let us therefore fear, lest a promise leave us. Enter into his rest. Because it was promised to the children of Israel when they came out of Egypt that they would see the promised land. That was a promise made to them that they would enter into the promised land. But when they came out of Egypt, they doubted and they were not happy. They were not getting everything that they wanted. Everything was not as lovely as they thought it was. There was some trial. Journey which will take a short time, 40 years.
journey shorter.
Amen.
The journey is more pleasant. But when we start to mourn and complain, it makes it longer. Because we don't show the appreciation that we need to show him. And so it was with the children of Israel coming out of Egypt. They murmured, they grieved. And almost millions of people came out of Egypt. It was only Caleb and Joshua was the only one who entered into Canaan. How it is in our first reading. The Bible said we must not follow the example of unbelief. That means in every situation we have to find something to give God thanks for. In every situation, no matter how bad it gets, we must find something to give God thanks for. For it says, for unto us was the gospel preached. It was preached unto us, I think it was unto them. But, it says, as well as unto them, but the word preached did not profit them, being not mixed with faith to them that heard it. So hearing the word is one thing, but having faith in the word. And you stand upon the word regardless of any situation. You're standing on the word of God, knowing that God said, I will be with you.
Yes.
And whatever comes, he said he will take you through the flood.
Amen.
And the flood will not overtake you. He will take you through the fire.
Amen.
And the fire will not scorch you. What more do we need? Praise the name of the Lord Jesus. There is a west sniper dream. No matter what's happening in this world today, there is a west. He says there's a west for me for the people of God. For people who love God. For people who serve God. For people who worship the true and living God. There remains a west for us. Praise the Lord. So no matter what it is, comes what may. No matter what it is, the patriots and prophets went through it. They all went through the water, they all went through the fire. But God bring them out. And David said, while I was young, and now I'm old, yet I've never seen the righteous forsaken. Nor his seed making bread. That's what God promised us. He will not let us down. So it says, so the verse 9 says, they were mainly there for a rest for the people of God. For he that entered into his rest also rest and ceased from his own works, as God did from his. Let us therefore labor. Let us labor. Work. Whatever we find our hands to do, let's do it for the Lord. Let us do whatever we can. Jesus said, the night cometh.
Yeah.
When no one work. He said, I must for the work of him that sent me. The night cometh when no one work. We don't know when the night is coming. We don't know when it's coming. Jesus is coming back. He's coming soon. And we know that he promised. Hey, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High. To protect us and keep us by his grace and by his mercy. Let us therefore labor.
Yes.
Labor. Because you know Jesus spoke a parable about this man who went, good man, who gave some gifts to some. Some 5 talents, some 2, and some 1 talent. The one that had the 5 talents, then when he came, gave him twice as much, he gave 10 talents. The one that had 3 gave him 3 talents. And the one that has the 1 talent, he hid his talent. Because he said, this man is an austere man. He wanted to pick up what he did not put down. And Jesus, the good man was not pleased. He says, take that 1 talent. So sometimes we have a work to do. But we have to remember that God called us to work in the vineyard. When I think what's happening now, look like, as Jesus says, the labels are few. Harvest is plenty. There's so much need now for the world. We don't understand how much need there know, one way to say, will there be any stars in my car? We don't want to just save ourselves, we have to save ourselves. But we have to save someone. We want to reach out to someone.
Yeah.
In order to reach out in prayer and fasting and reach out to him, because it's the last days. We don't know when Jesus is coming. But the science is telling us the Antichrist is here.
Yeah.
It's just not revealed, it's not revealed yet, but the Antichrist is here.
Yeah.
When you see what is happening in the world, then they only want to legalize abortion in America and all these things. It's the Antichrist. We're never telling children, not children, even children at the 61 at the age of 5. It's the Antichrist. What do you think? It's the Antichrist. So we're in the last days.
Yes.
And in the last days, it says perilous times will come. And we have to guard ourselves. And we have to focus on Jesus.
Amen.
And we have to be like the apostles who stood up because they knew God and they knew the power of God. We have to know our God. We have to know the power of our God. We have to stand up and be counted. We have to be standing up boldly like the apostles on that day when they stood up before the Sanhedrin Council. Peter stood up and he was not to say, who shall we obey? We will see who we must obey, man or God. We have to be in that place, so we have to make a choice.
Amen.
Who do we serve? Who do we obey? Man or God. But we serve the living God. And we know what our God can do. Let us labor that we may enter into that rest. And so, and in a certain place, again he says, you must get into a rest. See, therefore, if there remains a rest, that some must enter, that there and they whom it was first preached entered not because of unbelief. You know, I was just thinking about the story of Esau and Jacob. How Esau was out in the field. And he was out there hunting, because he was a hunter. And he came back tired and hungry. He saw Jacob with his soup, a pottage with soup. And he said, give me some of what you have. And Jacob said, I will only give you if you sell me a birthright. Now imagine now. So Esau said, what good is this birthright when I'm starving? You see that it's almost realized what the flesh needs. The flesh wants satisfaction all the time. All the time. It wants to be pacified. So Esau said, what good is this birthright to me? I'm thinking about the flesh. Man, we want to make sure the flesh comes to the body. And so it is in the world now. We want to be comfortable. And he sold his birthright. He said, swear to me that you will give me a birthright. And you swear. For a bowl of soup. And sell his birthright. And give up. And bless him. The blessing. Because he was supposed to be, the older one was supposed to carry on in family. So Esau was the oldest one. And he was supposed to carry on the lineage of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and then it would be Esau. But you sell it out. And sometimes you find people who sell out. Of which we have to look our salvation. We have to look through the spiritual life and see that God has got a blessing for us. A great blessing, one that we cannot even comprehend, one that we can't even understand. A great blessing He has for us. And if we keep our eyes on the Christ, we will receive the blessing
Let us therefore fear. Let us therefore reverence God. Let us therefore give him our all. And he will bless us more than we can even think. Seeing then that some must enter into his rest, therefore, that there will be the rest that some must enter. Not everyone will enter, but those who serve the Lord. We, the people of God, we have a hope. A hope which makes not ashamed. Seeing therefore that there remain of the rest, some must enter therein. Virgin, every day we get up, let us give God praise, let's give God glory, let us lift him up and give him the praise and the glory as due to his name. He's coming back again. He's coming back. He went away not to stay. He's coming back again. He's coming back to receive us. The Bible says, the trumpet God shall sound. And the dead in Christ shall rise, and we who are alive and remain shall be caught up to meet him in the air. We have a promise. We are now children of the living God. Now are we the sons of God. It does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know when we see him, we shall be like him. Around some of you, my friend, and you are my brother, even though you are my king. You alone are my strength and shield. You alone does my spirit heal. You alone, he is all. Without Jesus, nothing. He is our all. He is our all. All alone. Praise the Lord. Jesus paid it all. All to him I owe. Sin and God are crimson stain. His blood washes whiter than snow. There's nothing to lean on Jesus. Safe and secure from all alarm. Let us lean on him. Lord, blessing is sure, my dear. Bible says, they that continue to the end, endure to the end, shall be saved. Let us stay on board. Let us continue to give him the praise and the glory that is due unto his name. God bless you, my brother. God bless you.